Hi everyone, my name is Hannah and I'm from Girl Scouts River Valleys. At Girl Scouts River Valleys, I'm the STEM program manager, which is a super cool job. I get to put together events for Girl Scouts like you that have to do with science, technology, and engineering. It's super fun. It's basically the best job ever. So Girl Scouts River Valleys is located right here in Minnesota and Wisconsin. I live where the star is, in Minneapolis. Today we're going to do a s'mores algorithm activity. This is the first step to earning your Daisy Coding Basics badge. At the end of this video, you'll know what an algorithm is and how you and your girl can make s'mores using that algorithm. Let's check it out. This activity will take about 15 minutes to complete, with 5 minutes of prep and about 5 minutes of cleanup. You'll need 2 graham crackers, 1 piece of chocolate, 1 marshmallow, 1 plate, and 1 napkin. I actually don't have s'more stuff at my house, so I'm gonna make a substitution. That just means I'm gonna use something different instead. I've got graham crackers, so I'm good on that, but I'm gonna use peanut butter and jelly instead of a marshmallow and a piece of chocolate. You can use whatever's in your house. Computers help us solve problems all day long and all over the world. Computers help us communicate with our friends and family. They help make it easier to deliver mail. They help make it easier to make clothes. They help make it easier to farm. Computers do so much for us. But computers can't actually think for themselves. They can only do what we tell them to do. Computer scientists use a special language called code to tell computers what to do. This code is a list of steps that the computer can follow. Maybe it looks a little bit like this. It might be a step 1, a step 2, and a step 3. That list of steps is called an algorithm. That's what I was talking about before. We're going to practice using an algorithm today. Now, what would an algorithm look like for getting ready for school? Let's say you had to tell a robot how to get ready for school. Some of the things you probably do every morning are brush your teeth, change out of your pajamas, and pack your backpack. Some of these steps can be done in any order, but some of them you might need to do them in a certain type of order. For example, if I had step 1, brush my teeth, and then step 2, put on shoes, and then step 3, put on socks, there might be a problem with my algorithm. If we told the robot to head out to school and then pack its backpack, the robot would be stuck because its backpack is back at home. A computer needs to know exactly what to do in the right order. So computer scientists always think about the order the steps take when they create a code, just like the order for how you get ready in the morning. Once you know what an algorithm is, you can use those lists of steps to make a s'more. In fact, a recipe is a perfect example of an algorithm. In this case, our task is to make a s'more, and the recipe is a list of steps that helps us complete the task. We're going to try following that algorithm right now. So I'd like you to pretend you're a robot or a computer, and this is your first time ever making a s'more. I'm a computer scientist, and I'm going to tell you the steps you need to take in this algorithm. Step 1, take 1 marshmallow out of the bag and set it on your plate. Step 2, take 1 graham cracker out of the bag and break it in half. Step 3, put those 2 halves of your graham cracker on your plate. Step 4, unwrap a piece of chocolate. Step 5, place the piece of chocolate on your plate. Step 6, put your marshmallow on top of your graham cracker. In my case, I'm taking peanut butter and putting it on my graham cracker. Step 7, put your chocolate on top of the marshmallow. In my case, I'm taking jelly and putting it on the other graham cracker. Step 8, put the last graham cracker on top of your chocolate. In my case, I'm putting my 2 pieces together. Yum! We did it! We used an algorithm to make a s'more, or in my case, a graham cracker peanut butter jelly sandwich. Now you gotta follow step 9. Take a bite! Great job, computer! After you do something new, it's good to think about what you liked about it, what you learned, maybe what you didn't like about it, and what you might want to do next. Here's a few questions to get you started. What was your favorite part of the activity? What would have happened if the steps for our algorithm had been out of order? What was your least favorite part? And what else do you want to learn about coding? And that's it. You've done it. You've completed step 1 of the Daisy Coding Basics badge. you've learned about algorithms and how computers use algorithms to solve problems. If you like this activity, check out the rest of the activities in the Coding for Good and cybersecurity badges. Or maybe you want to check out our Think Like a Programmer journey, where you get to learn more about how computer scientists solve problems. If you like this video, be sure to give us a like and tell us in the comments below what you enjoyed. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to get more fun Girl Scout activities at home. See you next time!